to repeat what did yesterday, what have been said by Dr. Salasa, about the fiqh maxim, because I'm going to talk about two of those maxims that he talked about. I will hint to some of those points that giving compensation for the psychological harm in Sharia. What is the importance of this? Some of the Muslims, they feel discomfort when some harm is inflicted upon them, especially our sisters, hijabi sisters. They say that you'll get $1 million. Is it halal or haram? Is it very nice? $1 million, good.
أو أنت أيضا يتعدى عليك ب
or somebody will insult you or slander you because you're a Muslim.
بسبب العمل وما
somebody harass you.
فما حكم أخذ هذا المال
because of work or so. What is the ruling in regards to taking that money for that harm? So Allah will respond to that.
فال
شيخ أحمد psychological harm is good.
قسمت
مورال
بحثي أو بحثي يتناول أربعة مطالب في الحقيقة هذا الأول المطلب الأول
so this is the first the definition of harm and proofs for its prohibitions. I'm not going to mention the linguistic meaning of it. This everybody knows what harm is. The verses that mentioned harm, there are many various verses. Oh Allah, have been touched by harm, Prophet Ayyub alayhi salam, and verses like that. But I'll mention some of the hadith that talked about this concept of harm. There's some lights to be shed in this, and the sunnah is the best explanation for the Quran. So the most majority of the sunnah is to explain the Quran. Authority of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu
anhu.
Somebody give the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha, she broke the container of the food that Safiya brought it. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't get angry, he did not react. He said, he said that container by container and food by food, so you have to compensate with that. So you have to bring her the same container, the same food. This is the compensation here. Now it was not, this is the physical harm, but there's no physical harm. So the camel of Al-Bara, so it went to a garden and it messed up some of the plantation there. So Rasulullah sallallahu mentioned that all the people who have gardens to protect it during the day and the people who owns the cattle to protect it during the night. So if it leaves the stable at night, then they supposed to pay for the harm, and if the people of the garden have to protect their own gardens during the day. So Rasulullah said that he will take the compensation for what the camel did on Al-Bara. I have a maxim here. Dr. Salah talked about them yesterday. There is no harm, there is no reciprocating harm. And from that, that harm should be removed and should be prevented as much as possible. We will give some examples by removing harm from the sunnah. You have the research in your hand from Samra bin Jundub that he had some parts of the palm trees, and Samra bin Jundub, whenever he enters the garden that he owns some palm trees, so the person is not happy because his wife was there all the time. So the person told him that I will give you in place of those palm trees, some other palm trees, some other place. So he refused, so he went and complained to the Prophet ﷺ. So he came, he said, sell it for him. He said, he refused, he said, change it, change it. So he said, give me as a gift. So he refused. Then Rasulullah ﷺ told him, you are harmful. So he told the Ansari Sahabi, told him, go and take off his palm trees from your land. So you read more in your research papers for the examples. So removing the harm. The harm from the beginning is negated by, repudiated by the Sharia. So Muslim cannot initiate a harm, and he is not supposed to reciprocate the harm. And that's the meaning of no harm. It means no initiating harm, and no reciprocation of harm with similar harm. In fact, this sub-maxim that we remove the harm is to establish justice, is to comfort people that there is a system and that the transgressor will not get his way, and there is a way that will protect the transgressor. From examples that the harm has to be removed, that the wasiyah, the way Islamic will, Allah Azza wa Jal said that the wasiyah has to be perfected, so no harm comes out of it. And this which of the Quran. In Jahiliyyah, the person would wait until his wife finished the iddah, and before that, he brings her back, not because he desires her, but to harm her. So the Quran came and prohibited that kind of harm when you divorce women and they finish their term. So either you bring them back or you leave them in a nice manner and do not hold them out of harm. So about slandering. So when I saw the proofs for this non-physical harm, and I did not find much proofs, only some of the contemporary scholars, the punishment for the person who slandered by adultery, for example, it is not only lashing the back. There are three punishments in the Quran. Surah An-Nur, those who slander the pious righteous woman and they don't have four witnesses of the adultery, they have to be lashed 80 lashes. And the number two, their testimony will not be accepted, and then they have a nickname now, a new title. They are fasiq. So three punishments, except to those who repent after that, and the defix. So the slandering, it is not physical harm, it is a non-physical harm here, and how Allah gave a punishment for that. This is very severe punishment.
من الأمثلة عند الصحابة ما روي عن الصحابة ويعني وأخذ به بعض الفقهاء.
Some of the narrations from the Sahaba that shared and the person who two more than one person hires him for a job, the shared worker. The person who owns the hammam, the person, the porter, and the person who takes care of camels, and so on. The default rule that the hand of the shared worker is a hand of trust, is not a hand of compensation. What does that mean? That means he will not compensate the owner except by transgression or negligence. So he So the person is just to keep the money safe for the people who employed him. But when people became weak in their faith, Abu Yusuf, the student of Abu Hanifa, he said that his hand is the hand of compensation, means you have to trust, you have to be responsible. Hand of responsibility means he becomes responsible when the money is lost. And this is the only way that will fix people. So nobody will accept a job except he knows that he will lose if something happened to it. It is like the person who buys the clothes and the person who tells them. This is the only way that they make sure that they're not going to spoil what they're hired for. So Dr. Muhammad Zuhaili with us here, and he had a special research about the Islamic League. So he said that Allah Azza wa Jal wants to prevent harm before it happening. So you have to precaution and you have to prevent it. That's why jihad is there. Why? So prevent the harm and the risk of the enemies to attack. Same thing with the punishment for any criminal to prevent others from doing the same thing. The first right of purchase. So the person who owns, he does not be harmed. He does not become harmed with the new neighbor, that he does not have a choice in having. Now, what is the habit would be respected. So, like for example, here, North American Europe, the culture is very simple to have a compensation for non-physical harm, even if it's millions of dollars. You all hear a woman complains. The person, he drove over her dog, and she asks $5 million. And she said, after the judge asked her, so she said, like, why you want $5 million? She said, after my dog, I'm lost. He was my loved one, and he was like my child. And I see loyalty and everything, and I see compassion. So I forget all those concepts. I'm lost in this world as a human. And in some cases, they gave her $1 million for a dog. How a human is slandered? How a human is slandered? So the two lawyers told us through social media, or they said this damage, this psychological damage, can distract the person because of defamation of character. And this character is like the most important thing. If you take the $1 million for defamation of character, is this halal or haram? This is the question again. So here, the culture, and it has the conditions of a culture, because it is known, and it is common, and it is not against Sharia. As you will see in this research, it's not against the Sharia, it's not opposing the Sharia.
فلذلك أفردت لهذه القاعدة يعني أعطيتها أهمية خاصة فإن شاء الله تجدون.
That's why I give it lots of importance, and inshallah you'll find what makes you happy in this research.
يعني أمس بدون بحث خاصة أمس مسألة المتعة.
Yesterday the issue of the muta'a of the wife after her divorce. Don't you see that culture here and circumstances has great impact on her benefit? If we give her like the mu'akhar or the deferred mahar, and she does not have any families and she does not have anybody, and it becomes a transgression for the divorced wife or the widow. That's why we have the fiqh opinions to prevent harm from her. As Sheikh Salah mentioned, the other organizations would have to have other way to look, to perceive and handle these cases and deal with it, those family and social problems. What is our proof for the permissibility or compensation for the character damage or the psychological damage? Some of the scholars say that it is not permissible because it is not a physical harm, and the non-physical harm should not have a physical compensation. So the financial compensation, it is strange from the Islamic sense. That's how it is, the default, the way it was looked at. But changing of circumstances and cultures and the way of life and the necessity, it becomes a matter accepted. The main idea, main concept here, why our jurists did not look for this. It is very scarce. Abu Yusuf and Muhammad, they talk about it. And Sheikh Khalid al-Munisi here mentioned those two jurists and what they said about the ones when they healed and the hair is back, and then somebody complained, do they get compensation for the psychological damage now or not? So the Ahnaf here will be happy. Originally, I'm Hanafi. I wanted to state that. So it is so the people of opinion, they said they did not care about the Dalil and all that. See that how we are benefiting from the Hanafi school now. Ijtihad without thinking. Would it be? You have to use your mind.
صحيح احدهم قال خفف الجو عم يتناقش مع واحد
قال هو ديسكشن سو وان
سيد الله مر عليهم السقف من تحتهم
ده
ما في.
Somebody said that Allah Azza wa Jalla will bring the roof from beneath them. He told them, yani, there is no knowledge and there is no brain to have the roof will come from beneath them. The roof is above their head. So the school of Abu Hanifa, it is taking care of the opinion but not away from the text. So they did not deeply research it. Why? Because there was no harm, non-physical harm. People used to fear Allah Azza wa
Jalla.
And they were following the Quranic method, methodology. So commotion is commotion is prohibited, slander is prohibited, lying is prohibited, backbiting is prohibited. So now social media and all of that, this is haram, of course. It was not there in that level, but now it is there, it's a commonplace. And I forgot to tell you, this is a very strong proof about the financial compensation for the non-physical harm, that the goals of the Islamic religion, the Islamic religion, there are five, to protect five. Those are the five, to protect the religion, to protect the soul, to protect the mind, then to protect the honor, then you protect the money. So how you protect someone's honor? This is one of the main things. So when we take the financial compensation for non-physical harm, it actually serves the main, one of the main goals of the Sharia is to protect someone's honor and reputation. Ard is like, reputation is like where a person can be praised or slandered. I want to jump here to what you are waiting for. In practical American life, from a scientific perspective, those who say, professional perspective, those who said there is no, majority said there is no financial compensation for non-physical harm. And among the contemporary scholars, Ali Al-Khafif, Sheikh Shahata, Mustafa Zarqan, others. So who said that it is permissible to take financial compensation? Imam Abu Yusuf al-Muhammad, two students of Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi'i, majority of the contemporary ones, Sheikh Hushal Tawut, those names the Sheikh mentioning. Now I told you everything, and my resolution here that this financial compensation, it is recommended and it is permissible as long as it's not exaggerating to become an opportunist. Allah said, do not transgress and don't be transgressed. And the Muslim has to be like easy. And don't exaggerate. And Syrian ways, so just be nice. We have an example from the Quran, financial compensation for non-physical harm. Two examples. You know them, but you need to connect them together. I'm having a problem to choose a topic for Jum'ah, and now I solved it for you. So. It's a very good deal. Allah says, if you divorce the woman before consummation of marriage and you already named the mahar, so you have to give them half. He did not consume the marriage. He did not have a khalwa with her. He did not touch her. And he divorced her. Why he gives her half of the mahar? كسر خطرها. So this is for a psychological harm. So someone goes and he writes, he goes and do the nikah from one woman to another. So who's harmed? The woman. So Allah said no. So someone came to me and someone rushed. And he did this, and he did the aqd, the contract, the nikah contract, and then he said that mahr is 100,000. I was in Canada. He said 100 American dollars. They told him make it Canadian dollars. We're in Canada. He said, I love her and she's good and nice. I will give her 100,000 American dollars. I said, okay. Well, after a little bit, he divorced her. So now he's stuck with 100,000. Second, if he divorces her and he did not name any mahr, is there compensation or not? So give her a muta. It is psychological. So psychological harm, but it is financial. So we have a delil.
طيب نأتي لأمريكا. أنا الحقيقة استشرت محامية, وقبل المحامية استشرت لوير تابع لكير.
I talked to a lawyer from Care, and I talked to Munal Jindi, who is also a lawyer, and you have it in my research.
فيها نص إنجليزي.
So it has an English text.
كم صفحة؟ 177.
Page 177.
فكتبت لها رسالة فجاوبتني.
I sent her a message and she responded.
أي defamation اللي حكى عنها.
What defamation of character?
أول شيء الأخ عمر كثير. نعم. قال في نوعين من الضرر المعنوي.
There are two.
في يعني ندخل تحت.
Types of harm.
ضرر معنوي في أمريكا.
Non-physical harm. Defamation of character.
القذف والافتراء.
Slander. and other one is libel. And the libel means when a person says verbally, it is defamation of character, just talk. There are three conditions for that to be considered so it can be compensated. One, there has to be a witness, for sure has to be a witness who heard that. Second, and also the person who said that, this is not right. And the third one, that the plaintiff has to claim that it is really inflicted harm on him, and this is the hardest one. Libel, the libel means that he has to write something like an email or social media or something like that, written. The same thing. So now we have hate crimes. It is relevant to us. So somebody is attacking the religion of Islam, its color, or ethnic problems. He's not attacking our ethnicity or our color, but he is attacking our religion. Or belief. So first one is in civil court, if it is your person, but if it is against the religion, it's federal court. Hate crime, no compensation. But if you can prove it in the court, so it becomes an indictment for the transgressor. So this is hate crime. And it caused the damage to the transgressed. So they always make a settlement. Now it becomes an opportunity for the Muslims and the care that 30,000, 25,000 in another case. I brought it so you can understand this hate crime, but it has a personal damage. Especially for sisters, because of their hijab, she says, "Hasbullah wa ni'mal wakeel." Yes, Allah suffices for you, but you have to go to care for you. If it brings you $1 million for your hijab, Allah is good. You help your poor husband. So settlement will happen. Don't tell yourself. Don't go by yourself. No care. So care always said file through us and we will take care of it. They have 36 or 37 lawyers. They have chapters all over most of the cities of Nazis. They didn't tell me anything. I'm not promoting them. Allah knows, they didn't give me anything. And I have many stories from Kira, put some of them in research. The Prophet among the characters of the believers, the strong believer is dearer to Allah and better than the weak one, and both of them are good. Physical here is not the issue, even though I'm telling you to go to the gym and sport. It's not haram for the sheikhs, by the way. There's a strength in the personality, strength of character, strength of religion. With your firmness, and when you get your right against those who transgress you because you're a Muslim, this is a victory to your religion, and it is prevention to others from doing the same thing, and a punishment in Islam, or for any reason, all of it, the goal is to prevent others from doing that. When the Muslims came started doing it, everything hate crime went down. And inshallah, we reach a time nobody can think about transgressing us. May Allah protect us in this country, and may Allah preserve our religion. And you are the guards of Islam. And I ask Allah not to be attacked from your side. And now the mic started playing with me like Sheikh Salah. And I'm going to stop here. And I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive both of us. And if I did anything wrong, he's saying in English.
Otherwise, say something good for me. السلام عليكم.
الله مشكلة يا شيخ لما تترجم بالانجليزي راح.
شيخ احمد. We open it up to question and answers inshallah. Dr. Waleed, inshallah will give a 5-minute commentary on question and topic inshallah.
In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful, praise be to Allah, and may Allah's peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad. The issue of accepting the compensation, financial compensation for the psychological or non-physical harm I have from 185 to 200, maybe there is a mistake in the they mixed my there is a mistaken number in there. 185 to 200 is my research in the book. So this summary for that. This defamation of character of somebody else, or bringing sadness and grief to someone because of the threat, or scaring them also.
بحسب يعني ليست يعني القيمة أو التعويض المالي عن الأسياد متماثلة في كل الأيدي أو
so it is not compensating for one hand like all hands. So the hand of the calligrapher or the leg of the racer, if there is an extra benefit, psychological benefit for that person, so this has to be added also to compensation. Can we accept that or not? From the proofs of those who permitted that, to take financial compensation for non-physical harm, hadith narrated by Tabarani, this story of Zayd ibn Sa'na when he became a Muslim. It's a long story, but the Shahidir, the one when he wanted to test the signs of Rasulullah, he was a Jewish scholar and he wanted to test it. He found all the signs except one. His patience will increase when the ignorance of the person increases. So he wanted to test that for Rasulullah sallallahu
alaihi wasallam.
So he gave Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam 80 dinar for delayed dates. So he gave him cash, said, I will take dates later. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took the 80 dinar. So he told him the time. So he came before the term. He came before the time that Rasulullah promised him to get. He said, oh, children of Abdul Muttalib, you are people who are the deceivers. You are give me my right and this time. And we agreed, but even though the time is not there yet. So Umar ibn Khattab wanted to kill him, and he said, I will chop his head, and he scared him, scared him off.
فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم دعه يا عمر إن
الإصابة. صلى الله عليه وسلم leave him عمر. قال. For a person who has the right, he has right to speak. So give him the dates that we promised him. And he said, give him 20 صاع extra for what you scared him.
مكان ما روعه.
For scaring him.
هدده بالقتل وكذا أن يضرب عنقه.
So he said, give him 20 sa extra because he scared him with death. So this is the strong proof here for financial compensation for non-physical harm. The settlement for slandering with the financial compensation, those who prevented it said that the authority opinion or for مذاهب so that a person can forgive or he wants to enforce the punishment, but he cannot take the compensation from him. This is what was endorsed in all four mazhab. Because it will now everybody who attacked with zina, he wants money, so this will bring the hudud down, so nobody will be punished. So they said the rule of the slander, it is not the right only for the person, but it is Allah's right as well. So he cannot get compensation as an alternative for the haqq of Allah. Because there are two parts, your right and Allah's right, so you cannot take compensation in Allah's right. So you cannot, either you enforce the punishment or you forgive. This is the argument, but it is not an issue of consensus. So قول سحنون and أشهف from the Malik and Abu Yusuf from Ahnaf and Abu Ishaq al-Shirazi from Shafi'i, and it is one of the opinions of Hanbali school. So they said that it can be taken, it's permitted. So in all four schools there is an opinion to be taken. There's a settle, and there's like a settlement between the slandered and the slanderer to forgive him by taking money, and they are four imams. So this is a clear argument for those who say that they take the financial compensation. So also in qisas, for person execution for murder, so again it's acceptable to take the blood money instead of executing the person. So what prevents us from settlement in the slandering? I don't want to repeat, so inshallah I'll stop here. Those are the points I wanted to mention.
Inshallah, we have about 15 minutes until the session is over. So inshallah, what we're going to do is we're going to open it up for questions and answers. Inshallah, reminder to limit your questions to 90 seconds. And for the mashayikh or the lawyers, inshallah, to limit your answers to between 2 to 4 minutes. So inshallah, what we're going to do is we're going to start from my right side, and then left, right, left, and then sisters, inshallah. And please direct your question to who you want to answer. So if your question is for the lawyers, please, inshallah, direct your question to them or for the mashayikh. Jazakumullah khairan.
Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I'm very glad that at the end, Dr. Waleed mentioned the hadith that the Prophet, he gave him back his right and he gave him extra and he said, jaza'a ma rawata. Isn't that enough for the whole, to summarize the whole like topic? There's no need to bring other maxims or other rules, other qawa'id. It's a text. It's a text and a fixed text. It should be that clear and we all agree on it. So I don't know from where the source of the difference is. Since we have authentic text was mentioned in Imam al-Hakim, Imam al-Darqutni and others, and it's authentic hadith. Jazakallah khairan.
في الحقيقة يعني هذا ليس هو الدليل الوحيد يعني هو هذا يعني يدل على
This is not the only proof. And he's mentioned the opinion of the, some scholars of the four madhab. He said that you can take compensation as a settlement. And I did not repeat what Dr. Alini mentioned. There are other narrations, Muhammad bin Hassan and Abu Yusuf to take.
حتى لو لم يكن له يعني أثر مادي يعني شخص جرح آخر
ولم
يجرح وبرأ ولم يترك أي علامة ولا
أثر. A person who wounded someone and then they healed and everything, and there is no physical thing, but he psychologically harmed him. So
هذا العوض قال الحكومة تعاد.
You can take compensation.
أهل الخبرة في تقدير العوض.
And the people will evaluate the compensation.
فيها تقدير شرعي. فمردها إلى العرف والعادة و
is up to the the culture and the circumstances and all of that and arbitration of the people of expertise.
فإذا يعني مسألة التقدير فترجع إلى أهل الخبرة يعني وإلى الأعراف والعادات يعني بما يمكنهم أن يحددوا مقدار هذا الضرر وما الذي يعطى مقابل
ذلك.
يعني كان هناك مثلا قوانين تنظم هذا الشيء.
Have a system for that. So, like from insurance companies, so it is not the compensation comes from insurance companies, for example. So it is permissible to accept it. I wanted to add those who said about giving compensation to non-physical things. So they said that in our fiqh. Heritage, there is no, you know, so the compensation is for physical harm, like killing, or cutting, or amputation, or cutting, or hitting someone, or it is for financial loss, physical loss. So physical loss or financial loss, but how can we compensate psychologically? There is no origin in Sharia.
وطريقة تقويمه غير منضبطة.
And the way you evaluate it, it is not measured. So financial and physical, you can evaluate it.
المعنوي الضرر المعنوي. قالوا هذا.
But how can we evaluate the psychological harm? It is not available.
كانوا يجاؤون إلى ما يسمونه
إعادة
اعتبار. إعادة اعتبار فيشمون في السفر.
Said that you know bring somebody's honor back. So said that the person who defamed the character of such and such person, he retreated. He took all that, and he is free from that. So that was enough for bringing his reputation back and his innocence and bringing back his honor. But the main court in Saudi Arabia, and I'm talking about 2005, before this confusion that's happening now, before that. We want all the courts in Saudi, if that became too much now and commonplace, defamation of character, they said they will. They have to evaluate this financial compensation for that.
The people
are strong on the fiqh opinion, yet they allowed.
Assalamu alaikum. So, my question is for the lawyer. You're talking about defamation and how it is a crime in the United States. And about there is a valid reason for this defamation. If there is a valid reason that pushes this person to talk about the other one in that way, what will be the action or further step after that, if there is a legal action can be done from the person who was accused of making defamation or not? And what is the evaluated punishment for this crime? So what will be the judgment for that crime or what's rated as?
Assalamu alaikum, thank you for the question. So keep in mind that there's two systems in the US system. There's the civil system and the criminal system. And mostly defamation is not prosecuted in the criminal system. It's very unusual. I actually have never seen a criminal case of defamation prosecuted, but it is on the books in some states. Texas is not one of those states. So it's not a crime under Texas law. And what that means then, your only recourse is civil damages. So if the plaintiff, the only thing the plaintiff can do to the defendant is recover monetary compensation. okay, and maybe require them to remove the defamatory statements, remove the, if it's published somewhere, or maybe an apology or something like that that the court orders, a retraction. Now, that being the case, I think the question was, what if the statements were true? Well, then that's a defense. But the plaintiff still has the right to bring the lawsuit, which can be very costly and expensive to the defendant. So you've got to be very careful if you're going to enter into this kind of type of litigation with someone, because even if you're right, even if you're telling the truth about someone or some company, it might be very expensive to prove it, to defend yourself. And then, of course, you know, there are things that are available, attorney's fees that the court can order, but that's, those types of things are discretionary. It's up to the court. So you might end up in a very costly legal battle.
Can a person go to jail because of that?
No, not in Texas for sure. Remember, every state has its own set of laws, and I've never seen a prosecution for defamation. I've never seen a criminal prosecution for defamation. It would be highly unusual. Thank you.
Are there any questions from the sisters?
Subhanallah.
Assalamu alaikum. My question is to the lawyers about the answer that they just gave to the brother. What about if the defendant provoked the plaintiff to say what he said? In that situation, can it be considered as a defamation or not?
So if you can just rephrase your question, but if I understood you correctly, you asked, what if the defendant rebuts, provoke. So if the defamation was provoked, well, if whether it was provoked or not, if it meets the elements of defamation, it is defamation, no matter how it came about, okay? So he sparked the phrase, or he made it happen, and the other person said something bad, you can sue that person, even though you provoked it. Because the law here, the way you win in a lawsuit is you get the statute, and it has elements, and you have to prove those elements. If you prove them, then you've met the burden of proof, and then the defendant has, and the burden of proof shifts from the plaintiff to the defendant, and now the defendant has to satisfy a defense. And if he does, then the burden of proof shifts back to the plaintiff.
Anything you want to add? It sounds correct, right?
Yeah. Okay, JazakAllah khair. Any questions from the sisters?
You can do this for you.
Go ahead. Could brothers give her the mic from that side, inshallah? Is there a mic on your side? Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so I have two questions. My first question is that it was mentioned that it shouldn't be exaggerated. So who determines exaggeration? Would it be the culture of the people, or is there some kind of base for that? And then the second question is on the other end. Islamically, is it okay to criticize certain businesses if you do believe they are unethical, etc., etc.?
Hello,
who do you want to answer your question?
Oh, sorry, the sheikhs.
Exaggeration, exaggerated compensation, it is not befitting to the Muslim. A Muslim should be fair and just. Where do we take this? There is something part of Sharia called the general spirit of the Sharia. We take it from various proofs, Quran and the Sunnah and the statements of the scholars. Muslim always have piety and righteous, not to take what is not his. Even the American law allows you to take a certain amount which is exaggerated or not supposed. So this is just for you. You do not ask something which is more than what is usually known.
What is common among the society, what is known among the people.
So this is, if it is common and known among the people, then that's what our basis as Muslims. So what it is known culturally, it is as a condition, and the habit would be considered. So we're not supposed to exaggerate, but if the judge, out of his discretion, give something above normal for a Muslim to take it.
So
consider it as like from Allah Azza wa Jalla, so you can take it. But originally, so tell the lawyer, tell him 5 million. The reasons that those who did not accept, because said that, you know, applying the punishment or forgiveness, but can the absence of application of the hudud, as you said, that it is a right of Allah and all of that, those who said it's not permitted, yes, it is a right of Allah Azza wa Jal. It is a right of the servant and it is a right of Allah, and it is not clear for either, so they are both intermingled. So this will actually become a reason for weakening the argument of those who prevented also, that now there is no had the contemporary, so the had is not possible to be applied. So now it is a way of punishment. If we cannot punish a person with the physical Islamic punishment, so if it is going to settle for money, this will strengthen the argument for those who permitted to take the financial compensation for non-financial.
One more question here.
Inshallah, next session.
Every time I come, just...
Inshallah, you'll be first in line for the next open discussion, inshallah.